हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू सिविल दुनिया। दिस इज़ द वीडियो ऑफ मॉड्यूल टू। इन दिस आई हैव डिवाइडेड इट इन थ्री चैप्टर्स, चैप्टर वन, चैप्टर टू एंड चैप्टर थ्री। एंड ऑल्सो द थ्री चैप्टर्स हैव थ्री डिफरेंट वीडियोज। ओके, सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड विद चैप्टर वन अंडर मॉड्यूल टू, इन विच वी विल गोइंग टू लर्न entrepreneurial environment, identification of opportunities, converting business opportunities into reality. Okay, and in next video we will learn the chapter 2 and chapter 3. So let's get started. Entrepreneurial environment. Environment refers to those factors which has strong impact over the business. Business cannot function in isolation. It must regularly come contact with the environment. Various factors exist in the environment which are changing regularly. Changes are increasing rapidly and business in turn must cope up with such changes. Organization which remains passive towards the changes would gradually fade away. Classification of environment. Microenvironment. It refers to as small area or immediate periphery of an organization. It influences an organization regularly and directly. Element of microenvironment can be classified as consumer or customer. Customer is the person who purchases the good, whereas consumer is the one who ultimately consumes the good. It is necessary to identify who are the customer or consumer. What is their buying habits, taste and preference. Second element is market. It is larger than customer. Various factors are to be considered such as cost, technological element, distribution factors. Supplier are provider of raw material, equipments, other services. They have the bargain power and ability to influence the business. Next element is organization. Organization can be classified owners, that is individual shareholder or group who have a stake or interest in the organization. Board of directors who are elected by shareholder and is the in charge of general management of the organization. Employ the person actually work in the organization. Next one is intermediary. Agents, broker, middlemen have an ability to exert the considerable influence over the organization. Competitors. They may be direct, indirect, identifying and diagnosing type of competitor. Their composition, resources used and the ability to influence the organization is to be identified. Competitors not only share market but also share profit. Second is microenvironment. It refers to as a largely external element to the enterprise which is beyond the control of the organization but which has an ability to influence the business. Elements of the microenvironment are classified as below. Like demographic environment. Demographic denotes population in an area, district and country. Factors such as age or income ability or income ability to influence the business. Few factors can be elaborated as population size, changes in the population, birth rate, death and ability to influence the business. Next is geographic distribution. Shift change in the population from non-metropolitan to metropolitan will have an impact on the company's strategy. Next is income distribution. Changes in the level of income, purchasing power, saving pattern will affect the business. Next element is ethnic mix. Factors such as changes in the ethnic mix of population with regard to product or service delivery, will the new services or product demanded or whether the existing one is to be modified. Ability of the manager to manage the culturally diverse workforce. Next element is economic environment. Factors such as money market, raw material components, supply market influence the supply, purchasing power depends upon income distribution and circulation of money as well as savings. Next is technological environment. Technology are growing rapidly. It can be considered both opportunity and threat. Opportunity for those business which can take advantage of it, how threat as to those business which cannot take the advantage of it. Organization must identify the technology investment and additional technology, positive and negative effect of the same. Next element is political legal issues environment. The type of government in power, political pressure, various rule regulations, laws relating to companies, competition, labor, foreign exchange is to be considered and have an impact on the business. Social factor environment. It consists of factor like human relation and the impact of social and cultural values which has a hearing on the business factor, such as role of business in society, environment pollution, role of women in society, education level, awareness and consciousness of rights, effective utilization of labor and non-exploitation of labor. Our next topic is identification of opportunities. Opportunity always exists in the environment. It is the entrepreneur who need to sense the opportunities available in the environment. Having sensed the entrepreneurial opportunities, the next step involved in enterprise creation or establishment is to properly identify the opportunities available for one in the given environment and then selected the best one from amongst the available to be pursued as an enterprise. Entrepreneur and enterprise go hand in hand. The success of business enterprise is depends on the compatibility of entrepreneur and enterprise. Potter's 5 force model to understand business opportunities. Okay. Potter's 5 forces. Potter's 5 forces analysis is a framework for industry analysis and business strategy development found by Michel E. Potter. It determines the competitive intensity. It also determines the ultimate profit potential of the industry. Here are the Potter's 5 force model. This is the here is potential entrants, here is buyers, here is substitutes, and here is suppliers, and this one is industry competitors, rivalry among existing firms. Okay, here is threat of new entrants, bargaining power of buyers. This one is threat substitute products or services, and this one is the bargaining power of suppliers. Converting business opportunities into reality. When you have a great idea for a business, the thrill can drive you headlong into an energetic launch. But wait, statistics show that over 50% of business fail in their first 5 years, with 30% failing in the first year alone. There are several reasons why business go down, but this early failure rate is usually the result of poor planning. For a business idea to succeed, one need to follow methodical procedures to ensure launch from a firm base. And the first question to ask is whether your idea is as smart and original as you think. First one is the research the market. You may think you have come up with a foolproof idea. But is there a market for it? Many businesses launch only to find someone else has already had the same idea and has got into the market first. Or the potential market is so small that you are never going to be able to make a sustainable income from it. You need to carry out a full market analysis of your idea and the target audience to ensure your idea is really going to fulfill a need. Start by doing a SWOT analysis on your proposal, defining all the strength, weakness, opportunities and threats associated with it. Involve all your business associates or friends and family members. If you are working alone, going through the process will help you to evaluate and refine the concept at a high level. Question to ask include, okay, what demand is there for your idea? Ask question from you, if it is a product, who will buy it? Then again a question, if it is a services, who will use it? Again ask a question, who else in the UAE does this already? Are they successful and if so, why? What price can you put on your product or service? As you build up answers to these questions, you will form a clearer picture of whether or not your idea is sound. If it is not, let it go. Second is, compile a financial plan. If your market research is positive and you decide to proceed, the next step is to put together a financial forecast. This will become a valuable guide when you are up and running and is essential if you are applying for funding. The more thorough your market research and your financial plan, the better chance you stand of securing investment. This also applies if you are relying on friends and family for launch capital, often the preferable option because the terms are more favorable. But take a professional approach and make sure you have an agreement in writing. There is nothing like unpaid debts to turn a relationship sour. Your financial plan is a key part of your overall business plan, forecasting how the figures will add up. It needs to include sound estimates of overheads, cash flow, income, profit loss and investment stages. Usually projected over 3 to 5 years, of course, these figures will be largely theoretical, but they need to be based on reality. So, do your research, an accountant or business startup consultant will be able to help you. Third point is, position your product or service. So, you have ascertained that there is a market for your idea and that the figures work out. Now it's time to prepare your idea for market. You need to be able to describe quickly and clearly what it is you are selling. Potential customers have a very short attention span, so you need to grab them in a matter of seconds. Start with the benefits. What will your product or service do for its customers? What need or problem will it satisfy? Explain it in language that your target customers will understand in under 30 seconds. When Steve Jobs of Apple launched the iPod in 2001, he did not describe the new devices as an MP3 player with a 5GB hard drive. He introduced it as a thousand songs in your pocket. The audience understood the proposition immediately. When you are happy with your messaging, test it on friends and family or your startup consultant. Fourth point is, build your brand. The most successful business are instantly recognizable in many ways. Their name and logo, their step line, their colors, their use of imagery, their tone of voice, all these factors make up their brand. You don't have to be a large established company to have a strong brand. By paying attention to all these aspects, you can build a new brand that quickly catches on and gains recognition. Consistency is key. Your brand needs to be an unwavering reflection of your values, but it also needs to reflect the values of your target customers. You can develop your brand personality by thinking of your product or service as a person or an animal. For example, with the help of a branding expert, you can translate your brand personality into a look and feel the tone of voice. With brand guidelines to follow for consistency, it is the consistent application of these guidelines across all your marketing that gives your idea life as a brand. Fifth point is, set up a legal company. With your big idea developed and tested, you are now at the stage to formally set up your business. There are various ways you can do this in the UAE. Cutting corners, though, could jeopardize your company before it even starts. The best approach to setting up a legal company is to use a reputable company formation specialist. They will listen to your needs, explain the options, and propose the best way forward. They can also complete all the paperwork, set up a corporate bank account, and make sure you stay legally compliant. Patience is the key when turning a business idea into reality. Applying the above steps in order should help avoid the pitfalls of building your house on flimsy foundations. Most importantly, share the process. Listen to constructive criticism and take professional advice. After all, this could be a life-defining venture. Thanks for watching this video. If you gain some knowledge from here, please like this video and stay tuned with Civil Duniya for more videos on entrepreneurship development, as well as for more updates on civil engineering. Thanks for watching.